Hi everybody, my name is Kieran Carter and today I'm going to teach you about ISO, aperture and shutter speed. So ISO, pretty basic, as you can see by this image here. When increasing the ISO, the image starts to become brighter. When decreasing the ISO, it becomes darker. But when you increase the ISO past about 1000, it starts to become more grainy, especially in low-end cameras. In higher-end cameras, you can get the ISO up to about 26,000 before it becomes grainy. And that's the same with newer cameras that are coming out with better software. So also there's aperture. Aperture is represented by the f-stop on your camera. So a lower f-stop means you're going to have more background blur, but you're also going to get a lighter image, as this image here shows you. But a higher f-stop, in this image here, you get a darker image, and also you get less background blur, so there's no depth of field coming through. And shutter speed. So shutter speed, as the name suggests, is the speed of the shutter. Fast shutter speed means that you're going to capture action shots and let's say the flight of a hummingbird. A slower shutter speed means you're going to capture things over a longer period of time. So you're going to get much more motion blur in an image. A slower shutter speed is good for nighttime photography and let's say a water flowing over a longer period of time. You're going to see the blur of that water going over that waterfall. Yeah, so that's all for today. Thank you very much. And in the next episode, I'm going to dive more into ISO, aperture, and shutter speed, how you can take advantage of those three things to make your image look spectacular.